Get ready for the dictation. Dictation will start in 5 seconds. Start. Another thing that is to be welcomed is that he is going to provide more accommodation and more seats to the second class passengers by gradually withdrawing the first class AC coaches and the first class coaches. I hope while withdrawing these facilities and extending them to the second class passengers, the existing comforts and facilities of the second class would further improve. I hope in all second class carriages, cushioned seats and are going to be provided. Socialism is not leveling down, but socialism is leveling up. When we withdraw facilities from the higher level, the facilities for the lower level should be improved so that the traveling comforts for the lower level improve. Another innovative idea that Sri George Fernandez has thought of amidst the constraints of resources is financing the West Coast Railway Line, which is popularly called the Concord Railway Line. This railway line was initiated when Professor Madhu Dantavait was the railway minister about 12 years ago. Once that government went out of power, this scheme got put into cold storage. Of course, in the last year's budget, Shri Madhav Rao Sindh had made some provision for construction of the line from Mangalore to Udupi, but the construction work did not start. Now, Sri George Fernandez has come out with a novel idea of associating the states which are going to benefit out of it, that is Maharashtra, Goa and Karnataka. By raising certain contributions from these three states, and certain contributions from the railways as well as from the general exchequer. If this scheme had not been thought of and if this had not been taken up in the normal course and under the normal procedure, this railway construction would have taken 15 years to complete. Now that a new method of financing this project has been initiated, the railway minister has promised that construction of this railway line is going to be completed within 5 years. I wish that this scheme succeeds, not that it succeeds for the sake of the Konkan Railway, but this would open up a new era for taking up other essential constructions where those projects could not be taken up because of shortage of funds. I hope the railway minister, who is a person of many ideas, many innovative ideas, would also think in terms of, if possible, self-financing schemes. Every year costs go up. Any project that is done today is cheaper than it would be tomorrow. He in his status paper has asked whether the money should come from the central government or whether it should come from the Railway Finance Corporation or from market borrowings, where it is going to cost a little more. In any case, I personally feel that these projects, important projects, should not lag behind on the ground of funds not coming from the central government or state governments. Even if it is costly, the money should be borrowed from the Railway Finance Corporation. Stop.